Well, hello everybody, and welcome to Home Group or Bible Study. The reason we're like this is because I left my camera stand at home, and my wife was going to use it, so she's got it at home, so I could do it like this. If you're listening to this, it's because you're a part of Home Group, which means you're actually studying out the messages here at the church and discussing them. You may be just getting this as kind of a update or a kind of a connection to the church if you're involved with other topical studies or Bible studies meeting around the area. Again, we've got small groups meeting in Chittenango, Canastota, Wampsville, Oneida, and Oneida Castle. Awesome. So this past week, I didn't preach. Elder Stan Dilbert preached. All right, so that's going to give you an opportunity to go out ahead of me with this the study that we're doing. We just started a new series of messages called The Truth in Plain Sight, The Parables of Jesus. And last week we studied, or 2 weeks ago, we studied out the parable of the hidden treasure and the pearl of great price. So next week, I'm going to be getting into the parable of the lost sheep that's actually listed in Luke chapter 15, 1 through 7. So I'd like you guys to get out ahead of me and begin to study this parable. And then, you know, if you're in a home group that's actually studying this, you can actually talk through it. If you're not, you're just a part of another Bible study, maybe you can think about this and study this at home. And then when you come into church on Sunday, that'll kind of help you with what we're going to be studying out, because there's actually a lot of information in this parable. So that's what I want you to take a look at. In this parable, there are four groups of people, and I don't want to go into too many details because I want you to study this out on your own ahead of time. It's a parable of the lost sheep, a shepherd who goes after a lost sheep. He leaves all the sheep behind. He had a small flock, which was usually 50 to 200 head. Anything over 250, 300 head was actually back then considered a pretty large flock. So the shepherd has this large flock. He loses the sheep. He gets the sheep back, and he invites all of his neighbors and relatives in to celebrate with him. Okay, so that's kind of what the parable is about. So there's four groups of people. And what I want you to do is to identify, based off of this, who God, Jesus is referring to within these four groups of people. So we have the shepherd. So who is the shepherd? We have the lost sheep. Who is the lost sheep? We have the sheep that he left behind. Who are they? And finally, we have the neighbors and the friends who rejoice. Okay? So study those out. Ask the Lord for wisdom. Bunch of different Bible commentaries out there. You can always Google this and get some help out there. Ask the Holy Spirit for wisdom. And come ready, and it'll be really, really good. All right? Thanks for attending Home Group and Bible Study this week. God bless you, and have a great rest of the week.